Hello everyone, welcome back. In the last video we saw how do we create a SAP chatbot web chat channel, right? So we saw that we need to go ahead and select our bot, and then we need to go to connect and then click on web chat. So what you see, whatever web chat channel you have created, that will be listed here. Now once you click on that, you'll be able to see the same code again, whatever I had told to keep it saved by copy pasting, but you can retrieve it again from here as well. Okay, so our next tag is to our next task is to basically go ahead and create an HTML file. Okay, so I'm not going to tell you in detail what a HTML file is. If you are aware of this, that's awesome. Okay, if you're not aware of it, I'm going to share this file anyways in the same Google Drive link where all other NLP code is uploaded. Okay, and we are going to make changes to this file itself. Okay, so what you need to do is you need to go ahead and copy paste these two lines. So let's go ahead and copy it and paste it here. So I have already added one line to denote where do you need to paste the script at. Okay, and although the indentation does not matter here, I'm going to do it so that it looks slightly more organized. All right, this is good enough. And then you have one more tag called meta tag. So this you need to put if you are planning to open your website in the mobile phone as well. You need to put this into your HTML file below this line, right? So where I have put below this, there is already a meta tag here. Below this tag, I have put it. Now, once that is done, you need to basically save it in a file called index.html file, okay? So if you look at the name of my file is, so ignore this, this is the folder name. So just create a file called index.html. The name is very important. You must have a file name with index, index.html. Okay. I would have shared this file with you apart from this particular script tag. Go ahead, and because this script tag will be different for each and everybody, because this token number and channel ID number will go ahead, will be changing anyways. So you need to copy paste your own script tag here. Now, once this is done, half of your job is done. After that, you need to go to our GitHub profile. Okay, hopefully everybody has a GitHub profile. Once you are at your GitHub profile, what you need to do is you need to go ahead and click on new repository. The repository name is very important. Okay, so the naming convention that you have to follow is this. So why I'm writing ngotham0 here? Because my username is ngotham0. So you need to write ngotham0.github.io. Please follow the exact same naming convention, your username .github.io. Make it a public profile, right? And then click on create repository. Please make sure that this naming convention you follow, otherwise it will not be hosted publicly. Okay. Then we'll go ahead and click on create repository. It'll take a couple of seconds to create that repository. Now, once it is done, it says that you can start by uploading an existing file. So let's do that. People who are not aware of Git from terminal, you can do it by simply clicking here. So click on uploading an existing file. Then it will give you an option to choose a file. So choose a file. Then this is the same index.html file that we have created. Okay, so let's go ahead and select that and click on open. Okay, once that's done, you need to say commit changes. Please don't forget it. You need to say commit changes. Okay, now it is saying processing your file. So what you would say is that there is an index.html file. And then if you open the content of it, you'll see the exact same content, whatever we have in our local. So this is our local, which has hello from Nishant. And then there's a script tag. There's a meta tag that we have added. Exact same file has been uploaded here. So if that is there, that means all is well as of now. Okay, so what we have done till now, we have created a repo. What is the format name of the repo? Your username .github.io, and then there is a file called index.html whose content is exactly the same whatever we had created into our local. So if you have taken care of these two things, we should move to the next step. We'll see the options, how do we host it publicly. So 95% of the job is done. Now we need to do only 5% stuff. Okay, so let's meet in our next video and I'll explain you how you can access this publicly through a publicly accessible URL. Thank you guys. Let's meet in the next video.